Like bits and pieces, honestly. Like I'm not big, like I'll watch it every now and then, honestly. But I'm not like super hardcore about it. Like I'm gonna watch this whole show and every episode. I'm a splurge. No, not at all. Not at all. It's like I'll watch a little short thing, be like 5 minute clip, and I'll be like, wow, I'm never gonna watch this ever again.
Yeah, so the first, well, from your personal experiences, what do you think is wrong with hentai?
I would say the fact that people can get off to it, but I can. So, yeah, I can't really
You
say anything
cannot
about
really
that.
say anything.
Yeah, I can't really say anything. That'd make me a hypocrite. And while I am a
Yes.
hypocrite in certain situations, this is one of those times when it just doesn't work. Something that's wrong with it is the fact that there's so much of it. There is such a vast amount of this, and believe it or not, they're all unique. Like, how does that even happen? Like,
Well,
what
it's
are these
because,
Japanese people even doing?
well, you see, my entire theory on that, and like I think that you can possibly agree with me, is that Japanese people are the masters of masturbation. If you can believe me right now, it is true. It's like, they know what can get people off. They basically animate everything that, like, your guilty pleasures, like, oh, one time, say you had a weird ass fantasy about pissing on somebody, and all of a sudden they make an entire hentai based off of pissing on somebody.
Oh,
Or say that you have this weird fetish where you want like 15 guys on one girl. They animate it to where it can actually happen. And
why
it's
would
just
anybody
like
want
Japan.
that?
Well, I know, but I'm just saying, like, there are a lot of fetishes out there. And the Japanese community has about all of them in just a small group of teenagers. So basically, you think about it, they go around and they animate the shit for their own people, but somehow gets leaked over here. Because I have seen actual animes, and I mean like actual animes, not really hentais, that like explode upon the sexual energy of teenagers and stuff that have way too much in common with these anime characters.
Like Kill a Kill.
Yes, like Kill la Kill.
Yeah. I
But
actually watched that whole series
trust me,
and
so did I, and I was very disappointed by the end of it.
yeah, the end of it, I'm not gonna say it, but wow, was that something?
It was something, and it was the weirdest thing ever. 'Cause like it all starts with like this girl trying to get revenge on well, for her
And then it
father.
just turns into this super obscure, what is even happening on the screen? I can't tell. Oh, that's butt. Oh, hey, that's a chest. Oh, fight scene? No.
But here's the thing is that it basically denounces the entire thing. And I mean, if any of you guys, and I'm not talking about you, Jacob, but if any of you guys have seen my feminism podcast, which was actually the first
I
ever
have
episode,
not.
and when I was talking
Need
about
to
is
watch
how
that.
women seem to get into pretty much every subject ever. And it seems to happen very frequently. And basically, I'm surprised that of all the things that women can get, like, frustrated and pissed off over, that hentai is not
They
one of them.
find a reason to get mad at everything.
I know. Sorry, my
Jeez.
little brother is in here.
That's all right. Mine's chilling right behind me.
Hold on a second.
Yeah, I'm home.
I'm talking to my friend from school. His name is Jacob, and we're a part of the Rock Band Industry Sect.
Hey
Why are
there.
you checking up on me, Gavin? It's none of your business. Tell her it's fine. I'm just talking to one of my friends. Sorry about that. I'll have to edit that
Oh,
out.
that's fine.
But
I can understand that.
But basically, Kill la Kill is one of those things that I like to call the modern anime trend. Because basically, back in the day, I remember seeing stuff like the old Dragon Ball Z type stuff, Naruto, Bleach, like when it was actually good, Spirited Away, Cowboy Bebop.
Oh yeah, Cowboy
and,
Bebop.
And Akira.
I don't know what that is.
It was that one where that dude gets psychological powers and starts killing everybody, and like it destroys his body, and they say that he's actually the living sibling of this dude who had all the power in the world, and his name was Akira.
Yeah, okay.
Like, I would suggest that one to you. It was all over Toonami for quite a while. Yeah. Which I also suggest for anime is Toonami. It comes on every Saturday night on Cartoon Network, believe it or not.
Yeah, they're starting to bring it back. It's adults. It's on Adult Swim, so
it's
get on
past Cartoon Network's.
Yeah,
get past 9 o'clock and you'll find it, man.
Wherever the heck you are.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
But it was... it was a weird little cycle for me because I grew up, like, depending on what type of anime you're into, I grew up on the old type stuff. I was an old school anime guy. Yeah. I loved Dragon Ball Z. Yeah. I loved all that stuff. Then all of a sudden, like, I hadn't watched anime in a long, long time. And
then you get back into it.
And guys,
everything has changed.
Yeah, everything has changed. But, you know... And what got me back into anime, and this is a YouTuber, which I would like to get you guys to go over there and support the guy, is Noble from Lost Paws.
Oh yeah, I love
him. He got me back into anime because of all the weird visual novels he would play, and it's like, this art style is amazing, and it's way better. Like, the graphics are way better than the old animes I used to watch as a kid. So I would, you know, I kept on watching his videos, and I was like, you know, maybe it's time to get back into some of that old anime, or like get into this new anime. So I watched Soul Eater for the first time.
Oh yeah,
Soul Eater really. Oh yeah, Soul Eater is a good one, but they made another series, and it's total shit.
Oh, are you talking about that Soul Eater Knot stuff?
Yeah.
Yeah, I tried to watch that. I found like 3 episodes of it, and after watching like 2, I was like, I just can't do this.
I don't know, because it piqued my interest because I was such a fan of Soul Eater, and I'm sorry guys, if we're getting on off topic, but the thing is that Soul Eater is just basically all based off the fan hype, and people have actually made hentais. Of fucking Soul Eater. They've made hentais of everything, like Sword Art Online, for those of you that are actually a fan of that show. I know I am. Or at least the first season. But Sword Art Online, there is tons of like little sex mini games for that game. And it's not even a joke. It's not even a mini game. It's like a full fledged game, but there's like different levels with each of the characters. You're playing as Kirito, and you can fuck all these different girls throughout the series. And you can even have a sex mini game with your sister.
I like how you say this isn't supposed to be a joke, but I think this is freaking hilarious.
Oh, trust me, it's the most hilarious thing ever. But it, like, I was a fan.
The fact that it exists, it's mind blowing, isn't it?
It is mind blowing, but
the internet is a weird place.
The internet is a weird place, but you know Mass Effect, right? Yes?
You brought up just a few minutes ago that we're getting off topic. What exactly is the topic?
The topic was supposed to be hentai, but basically,
it's still on
I know we're getting more into hentai. We just got off topic a little bit ago because we were talking about like old anime and new anime and stuff like that.
Yep.
But you know, going back to that though, modern anime seems to bring back this little sense of like, you know, who has the bigger boobs, Sakura from Naruto or some other broad from another anime.
That's the internet's fault.
it is the internet's fault because we have tons of obese little weeaboos that are talking about it.
Yeah.
And it is the grossest thing I've ever heard in my life when I hear these guys like talking about, oh my god, like Raven from Teen Titans is like the hottest girl ever.
Yeah, you listen closely when you walk through the halls or just during lunch our school. You hear this kind of stuff.
You do. It's like it was all over the place for a long time. And I remember having like a little bit of a crush on Raven when I was a kid because I used to watch that show all the time.
Yeah, when you were a kid, this thing went away though, right?
It did go away because like me, I'm interested in real girls. I'm not actually interested in cartoon characters.
Exactly. It's like when you were a kid, this interest that you had dies. Along with your child self, like you remember used to, like you can remember that you used to be like into toys and stuff like that, and you're like, oh man, these little action figures are cool, I want to play with army men like all the time. And then as you start to mature,
and then
this goes
you just
away.
Start playing Halo and Gears of War and shit.
These weeaboos, they're clinging to that. They've obviously got some family
or
issues.
Yes, or
you know that's
like
the problem.
Yes, but. Like, I don't want to get into
buddy?
Yes, who didn't hurt you? But
maybe take off your Google glasses.
Never mind, faggot.
Just walk yourself to the bus stop.
We have to stop quoting TV Filthy Frank.
Of course, yeah.
But but I don't want to get into this really that much, but I did want to bring it up because this is one of those creepy fan bases like the Weeaboos. The Brony community.
The Brony community?
Yeah, like, not all of them, because some of them are just, like, really into the show, and they're just, like, all about friendship and stuff like that. That's not the problem. I'm talking about the bronies that look up porn.
The people who like to dress up and go to these conventions.
No, not even. It's just like
themselves to anthropomorphized horse
people. Yes, that's exactly my point. Like a Twilight. Like,
yeah.
Okay, so a couple years back, on my old channel, I did a little Let's Play of Lollipop Chainsaw, right? And,
yeah,
nice. Just recently, like last week, I went over back to the video. And I was looking through the comments, and trust me, dude, you do not want to do this because, like, I'm not even kidding, because of all the shit that I got back in the day when I made that I fucking hate bronies video, because, like, one of the bronies tricked me into going into Rule 34, and, like, it was at My Little Pony porn site.
Yeah.
And,
It's a weeaboo site.
It's a weeaboo site, basically.
Yeah. It's anything that isn't real. Let's just say that and leave it at that. Continue.
But basically, I got really pissed off and I did that. But for all the flack that I did, because at that time, and again, this happened like a couple of years ago when I was finally just starting to, you know, cling on to different subjects besides just talking about what interests me. And I was talking about what interests the fans. And I was doing Lollipop Chainsaw and I looked down and pretty much every single comment, except for maybe like three, were all bronies. And they were all, like, giving me tons of shit. And it's like, you're playing a game that has the chick who plays Twilight Sparkle in it. I was like, okay.
I didn't know that.
Oh, trust me, it's all over. Like, Tara Strong. Tara Strong plays Raven. Twilight Sparkle and the protagonist from Lollipop Chainsaw. I actually have it over there somewhere.
Yeah. Because I can see what over there specifically is.
Oh, yes. Yeah. But, you know, it's just a little thing of what's happening now. And it is very disappointing because nowadays, like back in the day, sorry, I just totally confused you guys. But back in the day, it was about different things. You know, you could still like cartoons and stuff like that because me, I still watch the old Batman animated series.
Oh, yeah.
And I love that show. It was the greatest.
I kind of lost interest.
Yeah. But hold on a second, dude. I'm I need to.
Oh yeah, I've heard. You know, Zontan, stuff like that. But yeah. That's specifically for that purpose.
It's to give you a sense of sexualization towards your favorite stuff from when you were a kid. And like basically,
also they did
what was it? It was a that one episode that they made. It was like it's supposed to be a lost episode type joke, and it was my robot teenage daughter or something like that.
Oh yeah.
And
I remember that.
She was being fucked by she was being raped by 7 different rock dudes, and it was like the grossest thing ever. It was the weirdest.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, man, but it's
not 100%. You're like ruining my childhood right now.
I know. That should be the name of her channel. That should be the name of Zone. Is just like the childhood ruiner.
No. I was gonna say that should be the name of this video. It's like the shitty podcast episode 2, ruining our own childhoods.
Yes.
And then, yeah.
But you know, and even then, people, especially at companies like Nickelodeon, they'll slip in sexual jokes in our favorite TV shows.
SpongeBob. SpongeBob is full of them.
SpongeBob with prison rape.
The whole idea of SpongeBob, the whole overview of it, even from like a freaking surface level, still has it. I mean, like, just if you look at it from the surface level, and like, he's an absorbent sponge who lives in Bikini Bottom. There's a goo lagoon.
No, don't even mention goo
lagoon. And look at the squirrel character, Sandy Cheeks.
Like, no, dude, it's just a giant innuendo for nude beaches.
It is.
No, or what about this one? What about this one? The Krusty Krab is in Bikini Bottom.
Oh yeah, that too. How could I have forgotten the Krusty Krab in the Bikini Bottom?
It's like it's an entire just STD joke all over it. You know, like you have Sandy Cheeks, fucking Goolagoon.
It's riddled with sex disease.
Or remember that one episode when Gary caught SpongeBob watching porn?
Oh, it wasn't even that.
No, it was. Remember that. He's watching this like little plant thing do its business, and all of a sudden, like he's starting to get close, and then Gary pops in. It's like, oh, Gary, and he turns off the TV, just watching that nature show.
Oh yeah, okay. Oh my god, how could I have
the giant piece of sponge coming out of your pants?
I do remember. There was one episode that I did watch. There was a SpongeBob episode where SpongeBob was trying to give Gary a bath and all this crap, and then he's like,
yes,
"I'm now gonna assault your mind with subliminal messages," and then the freaking hillbilly girl. I'm sorry, I had to say that. To this day, I still don't understand that joke.
Okay. Listen to it like this. Okay, so that entire episode, you know, remember the part when they were pretending to be like pirates?
Yes.
And then he
dropped him.
Yeah, don't drop him. Yeah, and it's just a giant joke for prison rape.
Yeah. Look, doubloons. Drop him.
Just look at Sandy Cheeks as a whole. You know, Sandy just kind of sits there in a bikini.
In a dome. In Bikini Bottom.
Okay, so tell me, does that dome not look like a giant condom?
No.
It doesn't? It always looked like a giant condom. The joke was that she was inside the condom.
Why would Sandy Cheeks be in a condom? That doesn't make any sense, first off. Secondly.
She's in a dome. And that one episode, well, it was like a SpongeBob little TV movie type thing that they that Nickelodeon did as a publicity stunt. It wasn't Who Wear Pants. It was that other one.
Oh yeah, the one where he gets amnesia.
No, it was that other one where, you know, they're stuck in the vents of the Krusty Krab, and they keep on telling each other embarrassing stories, and then all of a sudden SpongeBob gets a turn, and he said, "Remember that one time when me and Sandy got married?"
Oh yeah, I do remember that. Wasn't that like Truth or Square or something?
Yeah, that was Truth or Square. That was Truth or Square.
It's been so long, like, holy crap.
Did you know that they actually made a video game for that?
Yes, I know, they did. I think I actually have it and played it.
I actually have the SpongeBob, the SpongeBob movie video game that they made for the original Xbox.
I have it for the GameCube.
Really?
That game was beautiful. That game was beautiful.
It is beautiful.
I play it all the time.
It implies many things, though. Or, okay, I don't want to get you off of a, off of this, but, okay, so speaking of hentai games, have you ever played...
Yeah, now we're going to get back to the actual topic. Okay.
Yes, okay, so... There was this little video game, right?
Okay.
And, it was a part of the Sims genre, but it was a kid's version of the Sims.
Oh,
and
God.
It wasn't necessarily, you know, like a Sims game. It wasn't like, you know, set up your house and do all this. But it was a Sims game where you were playing as these kids in this fictional type universe. And you were fighting off dungeon dragons, right? So I was playing that game because I was hardcore into that game. And I had, like,
this
all the best...
This doesn't sound like Sims, but okay.
But, it was made by the same company, and they kind of slapped the logo on there. So
like,
I was running
around. We made this!
Yes. And he was, like, he was sitting there. You know, I didn't touch the button for quite a while, and I was standing right next to the bed. And all of a sudden, this chick pops in.
What did you see?
I didn't see much, but like literally.
Who hurt you?
Who touched you?
Point on the doll. Where?
Was it here?
Anyway, keep going.
Keep going. The guy. Well, I was standing right there, right? All of a sudden, this girl walks in, and she starts walking towards the bed. And, you know, she starts laying down in my bed, so I'm like flipping my shit because at that age I was like, you know, that's my bed. I don't want a girl sleeping in my bed because it was like, it was a long ass time ago. It was for the original
DS.
Yeah, Cooties. It was around the same. It was around the time of the Game Boy and the first ever DS.
Oh yeah, the original Nintendo DS.
Yes, the original.
Was it like Game Boy Advance or Color? I don't even remember.
It was a Game Boy Advance game, but you could like, if you remember, the original DS was it actually was backwards compatible to where you could play the Game Boy games.
Yeah, I remember that. I had one with that.
Yeah,
it actually off topic. It broke a while ago. Anyway, keep going.
And I was flipping my shit, right? So I went over to the bed, and I kept on trying to get her out of my bed. I kept on doing it, and all of a sudden, I started pressing buttons, and then I pressed the A button. And then it was complete dark. It was silent up until you could hear the creasing of the bed going up and down.
Oh, no!
And remember, this is a kid's game.
Yes,
and all of a sudden, you know what? About 2 minutes later, the same chick that was in my bed and I heard the weird squeaking from, she comes up to me and she starts up a conversation with me, okay? So I sit there and I'm having this conversation and she's like, I have been gifted with the gift of life.
No!
And I started flipping out. I was like, what does that mean? So I started flipping out because I was still living with my mom. I still am, but still, I was with my mom, and I went up to her, and I was like, hey, what does this mean? And then my mom just, like, grinned and started laughing her ass off. I was like, what? What's going on? What's going on? Am I gonna die?
You're so confused. My God. What
am I gonna die? And he was like, you better start paying for that baby boy. And then I got the entire joke. It was
Oh
crazy.
my
It was messed up too because my
God.
childhood after that, I could not even touch the Nintendo DS anymore. Not even its new
Yeah.
stuff like the 3DS.
Yeah, just after that, it's when, after
And
that, you're
instead
like,
of
I'm
playing the
not
Nintendo
going anywhere near
DS,
this.
you know what I got instead? I asked my mom for a PSP.
Yeah, good choice, good choice.
And that turned out to be a little bit worse because I played that stupid God of War game. And then I was like,
Dude, that
no!
sounds spooky, man.
Because
God of War, that sounds
I got to the sex scene, and
Oh
like I
yeah,
had to
there is
mash
one of
buttons,
those,
and I
isn't
was like,
there?
this reminds me of something.
Yeah.
But anyways, off topic.
Again.
Yes. Sorry, guys. We haven't talked to each
We're
other
having
since
fun
like a little
here.
bit ago. Yeah. Well, anyways, I think what is wrong with hentai is just the fact that nowadays it's based off of all new type of things. Like, you look at stuff, and I know that you're not gonna like this, Jacob, but I'm gonna bring it up.
Oh God, what are you about to do?
Boku no Piku.
No.
Yes, we have to. It's for the
No.
fans. It's for the
No.
fans. Okay.
They might not even want it.
Dude, they want it. Trust me. We're talking about hentai. There's got to be a little bit of Boku no Piku in here.
You're gonna kill me.
I
I'm gonna
know, but
die.
I'm sorry, but we have to do
I'm gonna
it. But anyways, the dude. Okay, well, sorry. The first time I watched it was because a person who was a fan of my old channel, found out about my new channel, right? And
Yeah.
this is the first time I've ever heard Boku no Piku. So he shoots me an email. He's like, I hear that you're starting to make podcasts and stuff. And
Yeah.
I was wondering if on your podcast, because I heard the news about you changing it around to where it wasn't all about political stuff and you're gonna start doing more things like funny and stuff. And I was hoping that you could start talking about this. And he sends me a link to a video. And I get to the video and I watch it. And I couldn't even finish the damn thing because it was so gross.
Yeah.
It destroyed my brain. Not even kidding.
I'm sorry to hear that.
It destroyed me because like I was watching it and I was like, okay, so it's about a pedophile. Nothing new there. Japan, you have not surprised me just yet. And then I get
Yeah.
to the part
Not yet.
when all of a sudden, like he's going through and the ice cream drops on the dude's chest. And all of a sudden they start making out in the car, and I was like, okay, so a pedophile's making out with a kid in a car, right? And all of a sudden he starts messing around with the, down there, and she's, well, what I thought was a girl was like flipping her shit and
Turned
having like a
out to
total
be a.
orgasm. And he looked down and I was like, what is that sticking out of her pants? And all of a sudden he
Not a
took off her
her.
pants, and
Hey,
she
it's
had a
not fair.
penis, she had a schlong.
The
And it was
long
the grosses.
schlong.
And all
You're
of a sudden he started,
horrified.
and then all of a sudden I was just like, oh my god, this is gross. And all of a sudden he starts sucking on it, and I'm just like, nope, fuck this
Whoa!
noise. I shut down the video and I never watched it again. And I was like, I'm sorry, dude, I can't do it. That
I would have
is
given
the
up on
grossest
life at
thing.
that point.
And then all of a sudden the same dude sends me another link to a video, and I thought like I made it clear, this I'm not watching any more Boku
Hey,
no
you get
Piku.
this stuff out of here,
But you know
man.
what? But you know what? Do you know what the video
What?
was? It was Boku no
What?
Pico 2.
Mm.
Which again, the grossest thing ever. Because it's like two little kids and they're doing stuff to each other and it's the grossest. And I lost it and I was like, dude, don't ever do this to me again.
Yeah. Feel so bad for you.
I know, right? It made me so pissed off. I can't even lie.
That just
Anyways,
sounds like a headache.
and and I'm sure Jake could tell you this too because he wanted to do Boku no Piku for his first episode if he ever got the chance.
Yeah.
He was gonna be like, okay, so are you talking about plot? No, not this plot. Are you very familiar with genders? Neither am I.
Can you distinguish genders? Neither can I.
Because this is not a girl. Because this girl has a penis.
It's a guy.
It's a guy.
It's a guy, I swear. No,
it's a guy. Oh, no.
Yeah. All right. I think this is running pretty long. I'm going to have to head off.